This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in it. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for being a good Father, Lord. Thank you for this place of rest where you're calling everyone to a place of cleansing and refinement, Father God, where we can prepare for the increase that you have in store for us, Lord. Thank you for your messengers. Thank you for all of your laborers, Lord. And thank you for increase, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so today I am led to get on here and share a few, several things. And John 3, and I don't know if it was verse 3 or what it was, but in John chapter 3, John the Baptist is saying that I must decrease that he may increase. I must decrease that he may increase. And today, the Holy Spirit was just ministering to me, kind of like a computer. You know, when you do certain things on a computer, you have to close down everything else. You know, like certain updates or downloads and things like that. You can't perform them with all these other programs and stuff open. You have to close them out. So God, this is like a period, still like, you know, in that period of promotion. And there are some people who are on the latter end of the promotion, but before he can increase you, before he can promote you, before he can exalt you, there are some areas where you have to decrease. There are some areas where you have to be cleansed. There are some areas where you have to be refined. There are some areas of yourself that you have to die to. There are some areas of yourself that you have to die to so that he can give you new life. Okay. And so I remember this story, this came to me a long time ago. I can't even remember the details of it. The Holy Spirit just brought it to my remembrance. But a long time ago, there was some guy, I can't remember who the guy was. I have no recollection of who he was. Could have been a family member, could have been a friend. I can't remember who it was, but they were grieving about something to me. They were grieving about something to me. And I just remember being like, I don't even remember who it was or what they were grieving about. The reason being is because I was consumed with the awkwardness of the situation. It felt so awkward to me. I remember in my head, I was just thinking, Lord, make it stop. Or, oh my gosh, like what am I supposed to do? Because number one, I didn't feel comfortable. I didn't feel comfortable. I just didn't feel comfortable. I don't know if it was reminding me of an area in me that was not yet healed. I don't know if I was untrusting of men. I don't know if I was uncomfortable. I do remember confessing to being uncomfortable comforting men, actually. But I can't remember all what was going on in that moment. I was kind of like overwhelmed and paralyzed with, I couldn't mourn with him. I couldn't comfort him because I was consumed with my own discomfort. I'm like, oh my goodness, I don't know what to do here. I don't know what to do here. Like, you know, it's like they actually have like memes about it. You know, like the friend who, you know, like they kind of just go, I don't know. But there are some of us, if you read in Isaiah 61, it says, they will know you as ministers of the Lord. Well, God is saying like, look, we got to go and clean out all of this wounded areas in you, these places in you so that you can actually go out and be a minister of me, so that you can actually go out and carry my glory, so that you can actually go out and feed my sheep. Because you can't be how like I was them years ago when that happened and I was just sitting there in that awkward position. And we can't say that God never wants us to minister to opposite sex. There's a way to do it. There's an appropriate way to do it. Just like, and it might not even be nothing huge. Just like when I was at Pizza Bogo that day and that guy was out there trying to sell his CD. And I said, if he asked me to buy that CD, I'm going to ask him, does it glorify God? And so I didn't tell him that. I didn't mention, I thought this in my head or in my heart, whichever one. And I went inside a piece of Bogo and I came back out. And he said, I mean, I'm not blaspheming. And my music is not blasphemous. I'm like, what in the world? Like, who told you what I was thinking? Like, I was looking for an exit and the Holy Spirit was looking for an entry point. So then by him saying that, and he just started to confess all this stuff. If that was me some years ago, I probably would have felt awkward and been like, okay, or something, especially because he was a stranger. But the Holy Spirit was in control, and you know, there was nothing other than figuring out how did he know what was in my head. There was nothing awkward about the moment anymore because I had been made new in those areas. I had been made new. And so that was one of the examples that the Holy Spirit gave me. You know, that's one of the reasons we have to be cleansed and refined, because you can't go higher in ministry. You can't go higher in working for him until you die to yourself in some places, until you're made new, until you're binded up, until you are comforted yourself, okay? And also, because if those places are not made new, then, you know, just, you know, Satan know weaknesses. Satan know what happened to you when you was younger that still grieves you now. You know, there'll always be an area of you that's untouchable, that's tender, that's ouch. Nobody can touch right there, okay? And so that's why it has to be done. And what else? And the Holy Spirit was also saying there are some people that need to grieve as a family. There might be some parents that need to go back and tell their parents, you know, I'm sorry, I've always pushed you away when you talked about this or whatever. Maybe you need to grieve first and tell them, you know, the reason that I've always pushed you away when you wanted to talk about this, or the reason I've never been able to talk about it, is because really I'm feeling messed up about that myself. Really, I've never healed there, so I don't know how to comfort you when you come to me. Really, I think that was unfair for our family to have to suffer that. Really, I'm a little upset with God about that too. Or I'm very upset with God about that too. Or, you know, that made me question God's love when that happened too. So he was saying there are some things that people need to grieve as a family. There are some parents that need to go and apologize to their children. You guys might need to cry out to God together. Like, Lord, why did you allow that to happen to us? Why do we have to go through that? It's okay to question, because the thing is, he can't meet you in no lie. You know, when you're going around and you're saying, oh, I'm fine, I'm good, I'm okay. In other words, no, don't go in right there. It's closed. It's good. I'm good. Don't come in right there, Holy Spirit. Don't comfort me right there, God, because I'm not even mourning. It's cool. I'm good. So when you actually deal with truth and you say, I don't understand why I had to go through that. I'm really torn up about it. I'm really heavy about it. I don't like to think about that. I question, why weren't you there? And these are the things that God is expecting us to carry to him. Like I said, it ain't no beautiful things. It's not no praising things, because that's really not how you feel. Okay? It's really not how you feel. So he's expecting truth. Trust that he really is good. Okay, and the example he gave me, think about if it was your child. Well, I mean, some people, when their child comes to them to mourn certain things, they can't comfort them because they haven't been comforted themselves, because they're in denial about how they feel. But if you were well, if your child needed something and you had what they needed, but they were scared to come and ask you, how would that make you feel? Knowing that you have something that your child needed, they're suffering greatly, like deeply, like thinking suicide and stuff like that. You have what they need, but they scared to come and ask you. Like, how would you feel? Knowing that you could just make it better just if you had a known. Not to say that God doesn't know, but the way that he works, he's not going to force you. He wants you to invite him into those wounded areas, into those broken areas, okay? So I think that a lot of this may apply to people who have wrong done against them, or who are suffering a loss of loved ones, who are trying to cope with death. It may be death of parents. It may be death of children. Y'all might have felt like it was just too soon. I don't know exactly everyone's circumstances. And then some people just didn't get enough love when they were younger. Some people just, they weren't hugged enough. They weren't affirmed enough. Some people just didn't get enough affirmation and love from their parents when they were younger, so they don't know how to give it. But God is saying that's not too hard for him. He can teach you how to love. He can teach you compassion. He can teach you patience. He can teach you all of those things. The Holy Spirit can bring you every fruit of the Spirit. And some people don't want to let them go because it's like, well, if I let this go, then, you know, I've always used this as a reason not to trust people. Then I'll have to be open to trusting people. If I let this go, I've always used this as an excuse to be by myself, or I've always used this as an excuse to feel right lying, or, you know, different things like that. So there's, and in that sense, it's your stronghold. The Lord is supposed to be your stronghold in a time of trouble. And we've allowed this stuff to be a stronghold. Remember that false sense of security. You used to use it as security, but now it's a prison. Brick by brick, you've made the self-confinement. So I'm praying that people will cry out to God. Jesus, it's just so heavy. It's just so heavy. So many people hurting. Well, the Lord gave me this song. He wants to give your heart a new song. And he just reminded me of this song. I remember last year when I was in the kitchen and I was crying about certain things. And one day my heart was singing a new song. And so I'm going to sing it and just listen to the words or whatever. But there is no area of my life where God cannot dwell. He is the source of my living well. I've had dark places, He has made light. I trust Him in all battles, for me He will fight. I've got victory in Jesus, favor in God, comfort in His Holy Spirit, all power in His might. Worthy is my God, all glory to my God. You're merciful, my God, my God. So God wants your heart to sing a new song. He indeed wants you to give Him your mourning so that He can comfort you. He indeed wants you to give Him your heavy spirit so that He can give you a garment of praise, okay? He can do it, okay? He can make all things new. He wants you to give Him your ashes so He can give you beauty. These seemingly worthless things. Don't nobody else want them, I'll tell you that. I don't want your spirit of heaviness. I don't want your mourning. I don't want your shame and your guilt. I don't want those things. And there are some people, he said, how am I going to send you a husband? How am I going to send you a wife? How am I going to, you know, make you leader over these people and you carrying this stuff? It stops here. You got to draw the line. You have to draw the line. It stops here because God says, believe it or not, I don't bless mess. I don't bless mess. I consume it. I'm a consuming fire. You offer up these, I'm going to consume them. I'm going to burn them away. Ha! I'm going to burn them away. Just like, you know, they purify gold by burning all the dirt off of it. He said, I'm not going to bless the mess. That would imply that I'm going to increase your mess. That I'm going to promote your mess. No, I'm going to promote you. But first you're going to sacrifice. You're going to give me these burnt sacrifices, these burnt offerings. You're going to offer me this stuff and I'm going to burn it away. And the only thing that's going to remain is the pureness, the incorruptible beauty of you, okay? So, rest and be delivered. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the new songs, that the hearts shall sing. Thank you, Father God, for the new ministers of you, Father God. Thank you. I claim victory for everyone in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, amen.